Welcome to part 2 of the Atlas Copco STanalyzer tutorial series. In this video, we will be going over some of the basic operations of the STa6000, such as navigating the menus, setting up a quick tool test or joint test, and creating a Pset. To start, first you must supply power to your STanalyzer. This can be done using the internal battery or using an AC power adapter. I will be using a power adapter since I do not have a battery installed. Then, press and hold the right arrow button which says on for a second until you see the screen light up. The STanalyzer will now display the information on the RBU installed and check for a radio signal. After this, the unit will load to the main menu and show four categories: test, transducer, reports, and device. To navigate the menus, you must use the four arrow keys to change your current selection. The selected icon will show with a darker background when active. To advance within a menu, you must then press the button below the screen which shows the option select. Once in a menu, we now see the option back as well as select. The buttons below them will always correspond to the text shown above them, giving these buttons multiple purposes depending on which menu you are in. Press the back button to get back to the previous screen. Before we go ahead and get into the test menu, let's connect the transducer. For this example, I will be attaching the IRTTB rotary transducer. As soon as the device recognizes the new transducer, it will load in its information. Since this is a genuine Atlas Copco transducer, you can see the model number pops up on screen. To confirm our transducer settings, navigate to the transducer menu and press select. Press select again on current and you will see all the information, settings, and calibration data specific to that transducer. Let's back out to the main menu again. Time to set up a test. When you open the test menu, you are given two options: free test and quick program. Free test will give you two options: speed and track. Speed will show you the current RPM and peak RPM of your transducer, while track will display the current torque and angle information. These tests don't save any data, but are great for quick reference. If we back out again, we can select Quick Program. Inside this menu, we have the option to select Tool Test or Residual. Let's select Tool Test. Then, we must now select a test from either Quick Wrench, Power Tool, Peak Wrench, Pulse Tool, or Only Angle. If you wanted to test your joint instead, you would select Residual, and then select from the list displayed. For this video, we will set up a power tool test. After selecting power tool, we come to this screen. By hitting the menu button, we can start the test or change our tool and Pset settings. Since we are using the basic setup without an RBU, we can't save more than one Pset and don't have access to a tool database. Adding the QC or AA RBU will allow you to save up to 1,000 tools in the database and up to 1,000 Psets. By selecting tool, we have access to some general information about the tool and some basic settings. After using the arrows to navigate and change the settings to our liking, we can back out to the previous screen. Hitting menu again, we can now go down to Pset and change our testing strategy and settings. Use the arrow keys and select the values you would like to change for your test. Once you are happy with your Pset, back out once more to the previous screen. Press menu, and then press start to begin your test. You have now set up your quick tool and quick Psets and are ready to begin testing. Once finished testing, you can navigate to the reports section of the main menu to view your test results. That concludes this tutorial on the basic setup and functions of the STa6000 analyzer. If you have any questions or comments on your STanalyzer, please leave a comment down below and we'll be sure to include it in our next tutorial series. If you're having problems setting up your STanalyzer, check out part 1 of the series, which helps you put together all the different parts from the RBU to the battery. Thank you for watching, and be sure to subscribe for more updates and video tutorials from Flexible Assembly.